This is not a sob story meant to make you feel bad about the hardships of Asian elephants. It is not a video asking you to pledge money. It is a video aimed at sharing the secret story of elephants in Thailand today. It is the story of a family driven by their love for elephants, determined to make a difference. Where did the elephants come from, and why are they in Thailand? What does a day in the life of a Thai elephant look like? We'll start where I started, at the Bon Chang Elephant Paradise Resort with Bird and his family, a family made up of more elephants than people. Here, Bird and his family take care of 16 elephants. As Bird describes it, his family cares for two bad boys, one good boy, three babies, one of which is trying to unstrap his shoe, and 10 female elephants. The majority of their elephants are rescued from Myanmar, where they were used for logging in the forests. Where Thailand struggles mainly with the mistreatment of Asian elephants for show and tourism, Myanmar still uses Asian elephants as hard laborers, a job position which elephants physically struggle to fill. The differences in the use of elephants in Thailand and Myanmar can be traced back to one of the oldest Thai folklores about elephants. When Thailand first fought for its independence from Burma, modern-day Myanmar, the two kings, the Thai and the Burmese kings, met face-to-face and agreed to save soldiers' lives by keeping the fighting between themselves. If the Thai king killed the Burmese king, Thailand would be independent. If he failed, the nation of Thailand would remain as Burma indefinitely. The kings hopped on elephants and fought to the death. As the folklore describes, the king of Thailand, only with the help of his elephant, was able to kill the Burmese king, and Thailand gained its independence. Ever since then, the Thai people have revered the elephant as a national symbol of freedom. The Burmese, on the other hand, lack such a romantic elephant folklore. Coupled with the presence of more wild elephants in Myanmar than in Thailand, more of Myanmar's elephants meet a hard and more labor-intensive fate, on average, than the elephants of Thailand. Logging in Myanmar today is a messy affair for an elephant. They often work nearly all day, taking a barrage of beatings from the mahouts who ride them and work with them. A mahout typically works with an elephant for years at a time, building a relationship of trust. In Myanmar, against most mahouts' wishes, this relationship is abused. The logging industry in Myanmar is overseen by Myanmar military, and soldiers threaten mahouts who don't pressure their elephants to work harder. Almost all of Bird's older rescued elephants have the scars from spears and hooks to prove their past work history. Some elephants smuggled over the border between Myanmar and Thailand are often joined by the mahouts who leave their homes in search of a better life with the elephant they love and trained. While some make it across, numerous elephants and their mahouts are trapped in Myanmar, logging. That's where Bird's family steps in. They purchase the abused labor elephants at full sticker price, a purchase with a price tag of up to $33,000, and care for them on their refuge in Thailand. But Thailand is not innocent in regards to the abuse of elephants. Elephants in Thailand's tourism industry work a scheduled amount of 5 hours a day and are not fed during the entirety of their shifts. A healthy domesticated elephant should work no more than 3 hours a day, and while working, the elephant needs to eat. Eating for elephants is an all-day affair. An adult Asian elephant can eat up to 300 pounds, or 136 kilograms a day, an amount equal to their enormous size. Working these hours, elephants often get overheated, which can lead to health complications and even death. Hungry, overworked elephants are also more likely to be short-tempered and, as a result, more dangerous to ride. Elephants are also forced to wear chairs on their backs, which lead to neck scarring, shoulder problems, and leg problems due to improper stress on their bodies. Aside from labor, the ivory trade has continued growing every year since 2002. The markets for ivory in China and Thailand combined make up the bulk of ivory consumption. While many of the elephants genetically able to produce tusks are African elephants, the Thai craft of ivory carving continues to result in the numerous deaths of African elephants abroad and the growing piles of ivory hidden in Thailand. While the number of wild elephants continues to dwindle, families like Bird's are making a big difference. Bird and his family are responsible for helping 16 elephants get back on their feet. Each elephant takes anywhere from 1 week to 1 month to ride, a number which fluctuates based on the level of abuse the elephant endured. Some elephants' wounds took over a year to heal, and some elephants' legs were badly weakened and left the elephants partially lame. By helping get the elephants back on their feet, Bird's family is responsible for helping thousands of tourists hop on their backs. Here, the elephants go on a maximum of 2 one-hour walks per day. They eat all day, including while they work, swim, and play. A full-time staff, the family, is devoted to helping feed the elephants while conserving the refuge's resources. A single elephant can eat an entire banana tree, roots and all, in approximately 2 minutes. So the mahouts and the family collect food, cutting the banana trees, sugarcane, and various other greens just above the roots, so the elephants' food sources regrow and the elephants enjoy breakfast, lunch, dinner, and snacks every day. Elephants can memorize up to 40 commands in their lifetimes, and the elephants' Bird purchases were trained for various purposes and acknowledge different commands. While the young 10-year-old elephant you see in the video was trained to blow water out of his trunk, Bird's girlfriend, the very large 40-year-old elephant just hanging out, cannot. Bird's family even has one elephant, Christina Aguilera, who had an English-speaking trainer and is the only elephant on premises who responds to English commands and can even say thank you to you if you bring her a banana snack. The elephants here are never subjected to a chair. Everyone rides the elephant's bareback, sitting on the top of the neck, the safest and most comfortable place for the elephant. A second person can ride on the back, holding on to what can best be described as a rope with a small handle, wrapped once around the belly of the elephant. While riding, the mahouts follow along on foot, providing comfort to the elephant as well as a tourist on the elephant's back. After riding for an hour up to the top of a small hill on the premises and back, elephants are brought to a cool water pond, circulated by a small running stream. Here, the elephants sink down on their bellies, close their eyes, and enjoy the cool feeling. We got to wash the elephants, brushing the dirt out of their wiry hair and throwing buckets of cold water over their backs. The staff also takes the liberty of bathing us like elephants too. When elephants are comfortable and happy, they poop. Because elephants eat green vegetation and fruit exclusively, the fibrous poop is scooped out of the river and dried. The dried poop is later used to make fires at night while the mahouts watch the elephants, or used to make paper at an elephant poop recycling center.
Tell you to run all the way, all the way. Remember to see me, buddy.